Cardi B's chased and it can't tell me nothing. Bossed up and I changed the game. You see me? It's my big bronze boogie. Got all them girls shook. Shook. My big fat got all them boys cooked. Hook. We're from dollar bills and I be popping rubber bands. You know, saying to me while I do my money dance. Like, hey. Flexing on the gram like, hey. Hit that little John. Okay. 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 Oh, yeah, we dripping the finesse and getting paid.
Ow. Ooh, don't we look good together? There's a reason why they watch all night long.
I'm Dan Indra, and I am still a game designer for the...
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Okay, basketball fans, with me, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, I'm Ernie Johnson. You're watching 2K Sports, but you know that already. And it is Clipper basketball tonight as the Los Angeles Clippers go up against the Los Angeles Lakers. Looking at the Lakers, it's an opportunity for them in a top-tier matchup to rise to the occasion. These are the measuring stick games that push you to take your game to the next level. So we're right around halfway through the season. Shaq, a lot of trade discussions happening. What are your keys to making a great deal?
Well, it depends on your goal. You want to win now? You want to win later? A combination of both? Does your analysis ever make changes out of emotion?
Well, acquiring players that fit your system. You have to have a system first. That's the key. And if your trade looks too good to be true, it probably is.
I meant to say, do your analysis. Never make changes out of emotion.
Okay.
See, I was emotional when I was talking about it.
Well, I heard you. I understood it. I understood.
All right. You did?
Not really, but.
Me either. And now with the tip-off coming up shortly, it's time to send it to Kevin Harlan for the call.
It's game time in Los Angeles.
I don't care who.
From the Staples Center. All the crowd ready to go as they look to cheer on the Lakers. Along with Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and our sideline reporter, David Aldridge, this is Kevin Hart. Last out for the Clippers, they won that game against Sacramento.
And I know the defense wasn't great, but yet and still, their ability to stay composed was impressive.
But it led to a big scoring effort, taking advantage of every weakness, so any possession the defense wasn't aggressive on, they were on the offensive end.
And as things get ready to roll, let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's on the sideline. David?
Well, guys, we know how much of a trailblazer LeBron James has been. He's taken charge of his own free agency to ensure that he is almost always on a contender. He has made it clear he has no interest in being around mediocrity. Kevin?
You're right, D.A. He wants rings and nothing less. interconference battle tonight, Brent, you could feel the change in atmosphere when you go up against a rival.
No doubt about it.
It's amazing.
Not only the teams are feeling it, but there's something to the fan bases who understand, these guys, I don't care if we win another game, but we want to win this game tonight.
Yeah. It's important. It'll be Los Angeles off the tip. Here are the starters for Los Angeles. Bradley and Gallinari are the wingmen. Harris and Gortat are up front. And it's Gilgeous Alexander in at the one spot.
The knowledge that Ingram possesses, well aware that the D is going to hack him in these situations.
Taking two shots.
The former Blue Devil, Brandon Ingram, was taken second overall back in 16, was deemed as untouchable by his front office as they rebuilt the roster. He's a big part of what the Lakers want to do over the next few years.
And that one falls for Ingram. And it was Magic Johnson, Greg, who said Ingram is untouchable. Also feels Ingram can be an elite scorer.
Yeah, I mean, Ingram certainly has the makeup and skills to be a first option on offense, and when he heard of how highly Magic thought of him, it made Ingram want to work even harder. You can certainly see the huge leaps he's made as a scorer since Magic kind of gave him that vote of confidence.
Well, Greg, you knew that the Laker front office and Magic were going to do everything they could to bring in big-name free agents, and they succeeded. They got the biggest name of them all in LeBron.
LeBron coming to L.A. completely shifts the mindset of this organization. Team was very busy.
Hello.
It's a beautiful jam.
Never get tired of LeBron James in the air doing wonderful things.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Last game he had 13. Gallinari wide open. Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt. Here are the Lakers with the ball. Here's LeBron. Nice spin off the left rim and in.
You want to challenge LeBron to do more of that, but you just end up fouling him, so it's more points.
Gallinari right side. No good, shot missing. So the Lakers will take it the other way. And this is the first season matchup for them against this Clippers team.
Yeah, and they lost the season series to this squad last time around. Maybe a little extra motivation tonight to show they've improved.
The pass to Gortat. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Harris outside. Five to shoot. And there's Gallinari on the assist from Harris.
Well, for Tobias Harris to take this step, getting away from scoring and finding teammates to become a more adept passer, that's good signs. Just like to see the defensive effort get better for their ball club. They can't expect guys to miss the mid-range Jays every time.
Inside. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Harris has got his first basket.
Tobias Harris getting a little bit creative, finding some room on the inside and keeping the defense guessing with that shot attempt.
A lot of give and take between these sides early.
Yeah, and both teams look like they came to play. We should have a good one.
Stolen by Ball. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
And that's how to make an impact with defense. Once the steal is made, you know they're going to be scattered.
Here's Harris, and slam dunk by Harris.
All that athleticism from Tobias Harris showing that time.
Lakers have gone 5 of 6 so far from the field to start out the game. Here's McGee. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Ball's got 3 assists in the game. Clippers trail by 3. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Passes it to Harris. Down low. Here's Gallinari. That one's all good. Now he's 3 for 5 from the field.
Solid shot from Gallo. He knows he has a mismatch down inside. Sinks the shot.
It's LeBron with the drive. score the basket. His fourth. He's only missed one of his five shots tonight.
He's firing on all cylinders. Has to be happy with his 4 of 5 shooting from the field so far.
So timeout called here. The first for Los Angeles. Well, there's a ton of talk about Lonzo Ball, but if you focus just on what he brings to an offense, there's a lot to like.
Yeah, I mean, he just sees so much on the floor. I mean, he sees all the cuts and angles, both offensively and defensively. And we know his shot will be a work in progress, but it shows some improvement and consistency the second half of last year. And for all the circus that can surround Ball off the court, you forget that he is already an elite playmaker in the NBA. One finger at a time, I chopped him up. I didn't let my tummy, so I chopped it up. Hands off my body. Hands off my body.
Quick look now at the best free throw shooting teams. Fifth, the Clippers.
You know, it's really a team-wide talent. You want to foul to stop layups, but against them, you're not saving much. They'll make you pay time and again.
Here's Harris. 17 points for him last game against Sacramento.
Well, I think he was especially impressive on the glass. The defense had no idea what to do with him.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
The Lakers have gone 7 of 8 from the field to start the game. Very hot shooting. Here's LeBron. Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
Well, his offense should come with a warning label. Caution, flammable. He's connecting on everything. The D looks dumbfounded.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
Numbers this year at the line below 70, so when he's getting to the line, not nearly as effective as you'd like.
And that one misses.
This roster for the Clippers is in transition, no doubt about it. You think of the franchise's history, plenty of dysfunction, but over the last 5 or 6 years, they've been the best team in LA. Now it's a time for them to reset, try to find some new stars to carry it forward.
The Lakers have gone an incredible 8 of 9 from the field. Here's Ball. That one wide left.
And that's really a function of the offense not working as it should.
Yeah, maybe lazy play calling or just going through the motions on that possession. This often leads to a bad shot.
Gilgeous Alexander can't get it to go. And Brent, you look at the Clippers ownership group, the front office, the coaching staff. It's a different story now from days past, isn't it?
Well, it just feels a little bit more stable. It just feels like they want to compete at the highest level, and they will do the things necessary to commit to winning. And we've seen that happen pretty quickly for the Clippers.
Here's LeBron. Good for another bucket. LeBron, he's made half a dozen now, 6 for 8 on the night.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
And here's Gallinari outside, makes the bucket. Now he's got 5 field goals, 5 for 8 in the game.
This is a guy whose mindset just never changes. Even when they're losing, he's always going to be aggressive.
Down low, here's Bradley. It's tipped.
In addition to being superb on offense, Ingram is also a ridiculously good defender. His long reach really allowing him to collect a good number of block shots.
Stolen by McGee. Goes up, and the slam dunk by McGee.
And that's the kind of play you just do not want to give up defensively. You lose the possession and give up a quick 2 at the other end.
Clippers trail by 7. To the paint, here's Gortat. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Yes, sir. Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
Here's James. And some very quick points for him on that possession. LeBron's got 14 points.
Just don't touch him right now, okay? You're going to burn yourself. The guy is on fire.
They double him with James. From deep, Gallinari. And it's Ingram with the rebound. Lakers leading by 7. The drive by James, and that one is good. He's got 16.
This looks so easy for LeBron James, a powerhouse who can score from anywhere.
Pass to Harris. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. And Ball comes to help. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Three on the clock. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
And while we got a chance, let's look at some numbers for James. Averaging about 27 points per, 7 assists, and 8 rebounds. And impressive numbers, no doubt. It's the kind of run we've come to expect from him.
Synergy, all elements right now working together, and the game is coming so easy right now.
There's the basket and make it a double-digit lead.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Clippers trail by 11. Los Angeles calls timeout. For a long time, the answer always seemed to be LeBron James. But it seems fair to ask now, who is the best single player in the NBA? In your opinion?
All right, LeBron James. Didn't you just say his name? It was on my frontal lobe.
I was thinking
here.
It, and I guess it came out.
We have so many great superstars, but you know, after last year, his 15th season, LeBron James performing the way that he did, carrying his team back to the finals, and there's just no doubt amongst peers, and we get a chance to watch him, Kevin. LeBron James is still the man in the NBA.
Ditto. Some changes for the Lakers. Tyson Chandler is checked in for JaVale McGee. Josh Hart comes in for Brandon Ingram. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Ball. The Clippers also making some changes. Williams is checked in for Avery Bradley. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Gilgeous Alexander. LeBron, good.
Methodical in their approach. They have absolutely owned this first quarter.
Yeah, you can credit the play calling. Nothing really fancy, just imposing their will on the inside.
And stolen by James. And finished off by LeBron.
LeBron James and his basketball instincts are absolutely incredible. How about that one there?
Clippers trail by 15. Now the pass to Harris. To stop the run, and the basket is good.
Harris
has got 6 points.
Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
LeBron drives in, and the dunk by James.
And from the opening tip, they just crushed it. Yeah, you see it now on the scoreboard.
Just incredible flow offensively. Everyone's doing their part. Let's see if they can sustain this early momentum.
Beverley wide open. Misses the three. Lakers leading by 15. LeBron James again. LeBron's got 26 points.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
Rondo on the double team. And Beverley kicks to Gallinari. Nice jump shot from the top of the key. 14 points for him.
Yeah, this team would be in some bad shape, guys, if he wasn't scoring like this right now.
Here's LeBron, and the dunk by LeBron.
Somebody didn't get the memo. You left a clear lane for LeBron James.
And here's Beverly. He brings it up for the Clippers. 17-point game. Left side, Williams. Back to Beverly. And Harris, wide open, he shoots. Offensive rebound, Gortat, and Chandler sends it back.
Chandler takes his defense seriously. That's what he gets paid for, utilizing his outstanding length to stifle shooters. No defender is going to have a shot against that kind of play. He's just too tall to stop that close to the rim.
on the wing, Harris. Poked loose. Wide open look. And it goes down 2 points. Lakers leading by 17. Here's James and the dunk by James.
What a burst of speed. LeBron turning on the Jets, getting past the D, and the big hammer.
The Clippers shooting quite well in these early minutes, 55%. And here's Gallinari outside, hands it from downtown.
Danilo Gallinari.
Gallinari's got 17.
Well, if they're going to win this game, he's going to require just a little bit of help. Many of the shots he's taking are finding the hoop.
And offensively, they've done a great job here of staying in rhythm.
Well, they've been the better shooting team throughout the first half because of their patience and because of their shot selection.
Williams kicks to Gallinari. Over LeBron. And it's Gallinari missing.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
LeBron signing a 4-year deal with the Lakers. Greg, many speculated it might happen, but it was still a shock to many.
It makes sense from LeBron's standpoint. Son plays in L.A. for high school. LeBron has a lot of business interests as well. And also what's interesting is that when LeBron's contract ends, his son could potentially be coming into the NBA as a rookie.
Now, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
The first one falls. Well, LeBron making one of the biggest splashes over the summer, signing with the Lakers, and Greg, it happened pretty fast.
And the Lakers front office have been recruiting LeBron hard. LeBron talked with Kobe about his time with the organization and what to expect before making his decision. Kobe's words seem to be a big factor for LeBron. Once again, the Mamba doing everything he can to help the Lakers.
The Lakers with LeBron wasted no time trying to surround him with free agent signings, Greg, to help round out the supporting cast.
Names came in rapid succession after LeBron committed. Caldwell Pope, Rondo, Stevenson all joined in short order. We'll see how far this team goes, but you cannot deny how interesting things have gotten with this roster.
For three, Harris. Chandler with the rebound. Los Angeles leading by 21. The drive by LeBron. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
That's not a pretty thing. LeBron James driving right at you, full speed, and when he gets into the lane and towards the rim, he's going to make contact.
A few opportunities so far at the free throw line. He's made one, he's missed two.
Shooting two.
And he makes the first. Now about midway through the season, a couple teams starting to slide. And they're desperate to turn things around.
But does that mean, Kevin, desperate means you've got to make a bunch of changes? Or do you go back to some of the things that had you in a position where we were talking about you in a positive manner?
Well, you want to remember your mission statement, don't you? Well, you know, what did we begin the season with?
Right. What did we come out of training camp?
Yes.
What was our mantra coming out of training camp? And maybe late November and early December, we won 7 of 10 games. Well, guess what? Break out that film. Let's sit down. Let's talk about it. Let's show some of the highlights of what we're capable of doing.
Go back to what we wanted to be.
And then bring it into the next game and show that you're capable of doing it again.
Agreed. Ball's knocked loose. It's stolen by Rondo. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Well, sometimes Rondo's a step ahead of everybody, even the coaching staff, especially on defense when he swipes the ball away like that.
Williams for three. Rebounded by the Lakers. LeBron's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin. Starting to surge here, and we're only in the first quarter.
And I'm loving what I'm seeing, the passion that they're playing with up and down the floor.
Here's Williams. The Clippers keep it alive. A nice shot by Harris.
Oh, man, a hot start for him. He's hit five of his first seven.
And LeBron throws it down.
Orchestrating right now, Rondo should be playing with a baton.
Looking at the last game for the Lakers, it was a loss to the Kings in Sacramento. On the wing, Harris. Down low. Here's Scott. Great D that time from LeBron.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Count it.
Well, he's got a baton in the right hand as he's orchestrating what's going on. A maestro, if you will.
It's stolen. And James throws it down.
Nice to see LeBron have a straight line drive. Somebody fell asleep there.
6 seconds left in the first. 1 second left. Shots good by Williams. And so it's LeBron James making things happen for Los Angeles. Between his points and his rebounds, he was a star for him in that quarter. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. LeBron James is the all-time leader in playoff field goals made, and he had this to say about his ability to nail clutch shots.
I always feel like I got it. I always feel like I got it. In the clutch, no matter what's going on throughout the course of a game, even when you're struggling at times or you're not shooting the ball particularly well, I just feel like it's going in.
And you know, Greg, that's the type of confidence you gotta have.
The words of a leader. James has proven time and time again that he's dangerous in late-game situations.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And guys, the Lakers are pretty much in control here.
Aggressive defense in that first period. They forced several miscues.
But you just start to wonder, how do we get to this score at the end of one? I think those steals really establish momentum in their favor.
Here are the five the Clippers have to start the second. Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. Mike's got out there with Montrezl Harrell, and it's Harris in at the three slot. JaVale McGee's checked in for the Lakers. Marjanovic checked in for the Clippers. The Clippers shooting with confidence, 50% from the field so far. Just five to shoot. And Beverly kicks to Harrell. Williams for three. Tyson Chandler pulls it in. Chandler's got his fifth rebound in this one. Caldwell Pope with it. Williams picks him up. Got a piece of it. And we're about a minute into the second quarter of play. Inside. He makes that one drop, only a second and five tries.
Such a dynamic scorer, inside, outside, it really doesn't matter. Lou Williams is a huge threat to score, especially coming off the bench.
And they get it back. Beverly with the ball. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. The kick out to Williams. Connects from three-point range. Williams has got 7 points in the game.
Well, during his career, Lou Williams has been a decent threat from the three-point line, around 35%. Good at stretching out the court.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And the Clippers get called for the foul.
And Caldwell Pope, the Georgia product, when he's on the floor, it's for his defense. Can give you a handful of points, but what he takes away with defense is far more significant. One of the better perimeter defenders since entering the league.
That free throw missing. And with Caldwell Pope and his defense, he can guard any type of perimeter player.
Yeah, I mean, he has the long arms to bother small forwards and fast feet to stay with point guards. Really gives the lineup a lot of options in terms of matchups when he's on the floor.
great instincts on defense and is very hard to shake as he'll hound you through screens.
The Clippers in the past few seasons, Greg, have completely overhauled their roster. They are making some serious changes here.
Practically nobody from the team 2 years ago is still with the franchise. It was a complete teardown, and they felt they needed to hit the reboot button. Jerry West knows what he's doing, though, and he's done this before with great success.
Two on the clock, the three from Bradley. He's off on that one.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat. And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
And Beverly kicks to Williams. And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. The Lakers have gone 3 of their first 5 shots to drop here in the second quarter. Caldwell Pope with it. Williams picks him up. And Los Angeles guys shooting 49% on the game. They'll take that. To the wing on the left. Lets the 3 fly. A rebound by the Lakers. They host the Kings after this game. That'll be the second of 4 games at home for them.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Clippers. Los Angeles calls timeout.
And the second overall pick in 2001, Tyson Chandler, again, started his career with the Bulls, where he and Eddie Curry were supposed to be a new version of the Twin Towers. That never quite worked out, and Chandler had 3 different coaches there in Chicago in his first stint.
Come on, man. You know I come around and rock it. I'm right for Sean Price and Dilla. My mic is Thriller. My blows is trapping souls like Bryce and Tiller. The crib left in the awnings, and that's the very thing that gets me out of the bed in the morning. I got the bread in the corner, got my career in the sauna. I got no fear, dishonor. I bled and lived through trauma. First the fat boys break up, then Bow Wow retires, and now y'all disrespecting the king. I come through there with claiming they doing dirt and get to just disinfecting the scene. I'm what you call the epitomizer of getting dark. I will spit a geyser that'll get these guys on the charts to fit a liga of bars. I'm feeling like the dying on the permanent throne. Like the Quran, you can get. It's smelling like a megaphone in the coupe going into an extra.
And the Lakers making a change here. Ingram's checked in, and Los Angeles making a change here as well. Ilgeous Alexander's checked in. To the middle. Here's Williams, and they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And started hot, and he's only gotten hotter.
The Clippers shooting their first free throw of the night.
And they've shot the ball well this season in terms of their attempts, 81%.
One shot.
And that one falls for Williams. Looking at Chandler's evolution, Brent, things really started to change in New Orleans.
Well, he averaged over 12 rebounds a game there in his first season under Coach Byron Scott, and then a few years later anchored that Dallas defense during their championship run with Dirk Nowitzki playing out of his mind. But there's still a lot of talk from Tyson Chandler about the mentors that he had early on. Guys like Charles Oakley, Scottie Pippen, Antonio Davis. Those guys really helped him to stay on course as a young player coming into the league.
And not only can Ingram score from the perimeter, but he can also contribute inside. The way he releases his shot makes it very difficult to block. And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That's on Lou Williams.
And after the Lakers landed LeBron, the talk was about if they would add Kawhi Leonard as well. Ultimately, it didn't happen. Lakers want to keep their young guns in the end, and LeBron has said he felt that the team was ready without Kawhi and came to the Lakers because of that youthful core they had in place.
2 shots.
The first one falls.
Well, it's interesting to watch him because he's putting his body on the line to get to the line. We didn't see this during the first quarter, but he's making up for it here.
Gallinari, he's checked in for Williams. And so he makes both from the line. With today's superstars often joining forces, Brent, we hear some retired legends saying they wanted to beat their rivals, not join their rivals. What do you think?
I saw a lot of joining going on from some of the guys who make those comments, Kevin. So that sort of stuff just eludes me as to where it's coming from. This league has always been dominated by teams that have at least two, if not three, upper echelon
superstar players
that end up winning titles. So it's happening now. It happened then. It will continue to happen.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, the Clippers have hit the reset button, and you wonder how that affects their head coach, Doc Rivers. Now, he seemed reluctant to lead a rebuild with the Celtics, but he's on board doing it with the Clippers. Even though the Clippers relieved him of his title of president of basketball operations in 2017, Rivers has just signed a new extension that will keep him coaching the team for the next few years. Kevin?
Well, if nothing else, DA, he has guided them through some pretty dark hours. Thank you. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Shots, gentlemen.
The Clippers have long labored in the shadow of the Los Angeles Lakers. A lot of ground to make up for the Clippers.
Well, from 1977 to 2011, the Lakers made the playoffs all but two seasons and won 10 NBA titles. So in that same time, the Clippers got to the postseason only four times and just won one series. So yes, Kevin, you're right. That's a well that you're looking up from if you're the Clippers. But the last five seasons, they've been better than the Lakers. Much better.
And that one falls for Chandler. Do you see a lot of player tampering right now in the NBA?
Well, how do you define it, Kevin?
Well, if a player wants to go out and recruit other players that may be under contract with another team.
I see that a lot then, Kevin. I mean, it happens all the time. Players talking about what are you thinking about doing and about, wow, don't you think this would be great if we could get together on the floor in 2021? Let's try to.
But management doing it is a completely different animal.
Management cannot do it, although some teams have walked that tightrope a little bit to the point where they've fallen off in recent years. But the idea of players not ever talking to one another about the potential of being together.
Come on, right?
It's always happening.
And a guy who blocks few shots, KCP stepping up and gets all of that one.
Ingram attacking. It's good. Ingram's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And some guys just have a nose for scoring. And this one couldn't have been any easier.
Well, on the defensive end, this is a joke. The lack of awareness is exactly why this team is so far behind.
Here's Caldwell Pope. That one misses. And it's the Clippers taking it the other way.
They got to fight through things like this right now. His team needs him to shoot better. He's just had a tough quarter. Yeah, pretty safe to say that this is the kind of game that you just want to flush as soon as you get done with it.
And it's about the tempo, guys. It favors them. And just look at that score.
Yeah, I'm a little bit exhausted here trying to keep up with these guys, and I'm just watching. And they always attempt to wear you out.
Ingram attacking. Bucket is good. Ingram's got nine.
The determination of Ingram is simply awesome. I mean, maintaining control on the drive despite the obvious contact.
And Bradley gets it to go.
And not his quarter, scoring-wise. Just one of seven from the field.
Here's Ingram. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. 11 points for Brandon Ingram.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
And it's Brandon Ingram with the foul. That's his first foul. Kyle Kuzma's checked in for Tyson Chandler. So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles. Greg, as we get closer to the halfway point of the season, it's clear just how impactful LeBron James has been on this roster.
It is night and day from the Lakers of last year to this year. This is just how much adding a player like LeBron can change your team. He just does so much and opens up so many options for everyone else on the roster.
Josh Hart, he's checked in for the Lakers. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Harris has checked in for Marjanovic. Here's Harris. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
I get a feeling that he made that much more difficult than he had to. No reason why he had to fade away on that jumper.
And so it's Gallinari with it. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Here's Gortat. Sinks that one from the post. Gortat's got six.
And that's how you set up your teammates. Done with a little bit of flair.
And it's Ingram missing. Clippers shooting just 39% in the second quarter. Bradley, no one around him.
Avery Bradley.
And good as it just snugs right down through the net.
That's a really nice play set because Avery Bradley's shot selection is feet set, catch and shoot, scores.
And he can smell blood in the water. Excellent finish.
Yeah, when your opponent's down and frustrated, this is when you can turn it up.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with two hands on that stuff. The shot's good from McGee.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
The Clippers shooting at 46%, making some buckets. To the inside, and it's Gortat finishing it off.
He is a big guy, and Gortat doesn't play the finesse game. This is a guy who's all about strength. Forget about laying it up there. He's going to take the power approach.
And it's Ingram missing. Here's Los Angeles now. Here's Bradley. Another one falls for the Clippers.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
And that'll be the Lakers as it goes out of bounds. Lakers retain possession. Scotty's checked in for Gallinari.
Now into the lineup for the Clippers. Mike Scott.
Here is McGee. 8 points for him. Up and in on the layup. 10 points for him.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. And it's Scott with the jam.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish.
Oh, great awareness. No reason to take it inside there against the taller man.
Yeah, most analytics will tell you that the mid-range jumper is not an efficient shot, but you see how effective with guys like that it can be.
The shot's good from Kuzma.
Coaching staff high-fiving themselves there, watching that team move the ball around, doing whatever is best for the team.
And it's the Clippers with the ball. Inside, here's Harris, and slam dunk by Harris.
Always tough to work the closer you get to the basket. Nice job of finding an angle on the pass there.
And Kuzma slams it in.
And you have to have an appreciation for Ball's passing skills. I mean, he just sees the floor beautifully, easily working the ball over to open teammates.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Kyle Kuzma. That is his first foul of the game. And the Lakers with some changes. James comes in for JaVale McGee. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Brandon Ingram. Patrick Beverley, he's checked in for the Clippers. Here's Scott. He has five. And good that time. Scott's got 7 points for the quarter.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
He's hit the proverbial switch, effortlessly finding different ways to score.
On the wing, Scott. Banked in off the glass.
Mike Scott.
Scott's got 9 points.
I like that recognition. Effortlessly getting his teammate the ball in a spot where he knows he can do something with it.
And Los Angeles guys shooting very well. 56% from the floor here in the second quarter. And now here's Rondo, the fast break opportunity. The wide open look here for Kuzma. Off target from the baseline.
And listen, you can't design a play any better to get a look that good. Just couldn't knock it down.
The best players know that is going to happen, and you just can't let it get into your head. It's a shot that you want to take.
To the paint, Gilgeous Alexander. The dunk and the foul, a powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. Lonzo Ball picks one up. For Los Angeles, they have shot just one free throw earlier, one for one in the game. And the Lakers making a change here. Stevenson's checked in.
Shooting one.
.11 left here in the second. Here's Hart. And it's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got four assists now tonight.
Rondo finding his teammates. That is his greatest strength on the floor.
Beverly, the pass to Gortat. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Count the bucket. And he's got a free throw coming up as well.
They did a better job of getting it inside in that first. They've lost some of that physical edge here.
Brent, a major pivot for the Clippers last season, trading away the most important player in franchise history, Blake Griffin.
Well, the front office made mention of sustainability and production over cost and felt like it was the right time for them to move on. The size of that max contract, the injury risk of Blake Griffin and what's happened and transpired the past couple of seasons, convinced them that they might be able to clear that out of the way, get some flexibility, and rebuild the roster in the way that they wanted to moving forward.
Lakers leading by 23. James with it, picked up by Harris. And LeBron throws it down.
Power personified right there in number 23, LeBron James. Wow.
Fourth team foul.
And what a draft day steal for the Lakers, who were able to get Kyle Kuzma, who had been drafted 27th overall.
Yeah, Kuzma came into the league far more polished than anyone expected, and you have to credit the young man's hard work and how he was able to make such a big splash that rookie year. And with how hard he works, Kuzma is going to be an impactful player in this league for a long time.
One shot.
Free throw drops for James.
And it's the all-around game of LeBron James. Dominant scorer, great rebounder, incredible passer, and an intense defender when he wants to be.
And it's Rajon Rondo with the foul. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Shooting for Los Angeles.
And Patrick Beverly last season, excited for a bigger role on the Clippers, but knee surgery wiped out his season.
Yeah, and he's in the final year of his contract, Kevin. A lot at stake as he hopes to earn a significant raise from a salary that's been one of the league's best bargains.
And he makes the first.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
All free throws, good from Beverly. Patrick Beverly grew up in the west side of Chicago. He said it was a pretty rough high school to go to, Brent.
Don Marshall Metropolitan. And he was the head of a 1-2-2 full court press where he just racked up a bunch of steals. Can you imagine just not getting the ball ever over half court? That's because Patrick Beverly was up there playing defense.
Last break, the Lakers. Here's Hart. Yes, it's James picking up the assist. Hart's got six here in this quarter.
What vision by LeBron, always willing to give up the ball. They're just hitting a wide-open teammate.
To the middle, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Looks good, is good. Bucket number four from the field. He's taken only six shots.
Coaching staff high-fiving themselves there, watching that team move the ball around, doing whatever is best for the team.
Hart, no good. With one on the clock, that shot is off. And so it's Los Angeles, ahead by 26 points as we get ready for the break. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Doc, how do you win this game?
I tell you, every quarter we've had a two-minute stretch where, you know, guys are playing hard. They're trying to win. But you got to win together by running your stuff. And we're trying to make it up, and the turnovers are killing us right now.
I know you call that hero ball. Thanks, Doc. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
After one half of play, it's been a one-sided affair. Hey, everybody, welcome back. This is Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. LeBron James putting in some incredible work. He went on an historic scoring frenzy, tallying a ridiculous number of points, 4 rebounds, and 1 assist. After a subpar performance in their previous contest, he has come on strong tonight. His first half, sensational. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny, on the Lakers.
Come on, Ernie. What can you say about LeBron that hasn't already been said? The first half is just a microcosm of his old career. Everything he does on the basketball court. He shoots, he passes, he defends. It's getting boring. I'm tired of talking about him.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Clippers?
Way too soft in the paint defensively. They were all late on their rotations. Obviously, that's a recipe for getting cooked. And you know I like eating that barbecue chicken. They got to do better, Ernie.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks.
Thanks
goodbye,
for
folks. Joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
Wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. It's been a clinic out there by James.
And through two quarters, he's been lights out. And you know he's going to look to add to those totals.
And defensively, hard to force him out of the rhythm at this point because he has a number of ways with which he can beat you.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. And Los Angeles guys shooting an outstanding 53% for the game. LeBron and Kuzma make up the forwards. Brandon Ingram's out there with Lonzo Ball. And it's McGee in at the center position. And that's the group for...
Oh! So many years and the body still holding up for LeBron James. Wow.
And that was an Unleash Chaos replay, courtesy of Under Armour, wreaking havoc at the rim. Inside, Harris. Score the basket, his eighth. Harris. 8 for 13 from the floor.
And defensively, this is the opposite of how you want to start the second half.
Yeah, it's like four teenagers at home over the summer, just not enough activity. You've gotten your rest. It's time to man up.
And here is Los Angeles now. And James picks up the foul.
LeBron.
That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul.
Molinari finds Harris from the arc. Harris missing again. The Lakers shooting has been wild. 76%. That's just unbelievable. And James gets it to go.
Moving it around. 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
Harris outside. Harris missing again.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
The drive by LeBron. Sinks LeBron that one from the post. LeBron's got 8 points here in this quarter.
Yeah, hard to stop LeBron from getting in that deep. So the size, the speed, the power, the position. Two more.
Down low. Kicks it out to Bradley. Six to shoot. Lets it go with a three. And again, no good by the Clippers.
He's getting good looks on the floor, but he simply cannot bury anything right now. He's got to stay confident, though, because everyone knows he can hit those shots.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
On the wing, Harris. Harris missing again.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Yep, that one goes in there.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Assist. Well, guys, Kyle Kuzma had a tough upbringing in Flint, Michigan. He said they had the recession, lead in the water. It was like an urban war zone. We probably moved 14 times before I was 16. Basketball was my key. And his drive to succeed in the NBA
was born of a desire to escape that environment. Kevin?
A tremendous work ethic, David. Thank you. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Kicks to Gallinari. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. And Harris gets it to go on the assist from Gallinari. Gallinari's got 3 assists now in this one. Here's Kuzma. That one is good. He's only missed 1 shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
Oh, they own the interior right now. 10 straight points coming from inside.
Gallinari on the wing. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
Here's LeBron, and finished off by LeBron.
They hardly needed anyone else today to get out to this lead. I mean, he's provided almost all of their offense.
The Clippers have gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. He's covered by Ingram, and that one drops for him.
Well, he's like a carpenter out there. Great floor awareness, zipping the ball over to his teammates with ease.
Another one goes. Incredible.
What a game. That's 72 points.
He's been simply, Greg, sensational throughout this one. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by James.
Clippers ball.
Around halfway through the season, and a chance here to recap where all the teams in the West sit in the standings. You look at the Clippers. Here in the middle of the regular season, they've been able to get the 4th best record in the conference. And, of course, the Lakers. Right behind them, just 1 spot down.
And right now for the Clippers, this isn't the spot that too many people thought they'd be in this far into the season. They've really turned some heads with their play.
Some people out there still thinking they're going to fade as the season goes on, but I'm on the other side of this argument. I think they get even better as we go down the stretch.
Tyson Chandler, he's checked in for JaVale McGee. And then for the Clippers, Marjanovic comes in for Gortat. And it's Williams in for Gilgeous-Alexander. Puts it up. Off the inbound. Good. That's another bucket.
He's scoring at an insane level here, folks. The defense powerless to slow him down.
Yeah, he's on a mission, closing in on 3rd place all-time in scoring.
And Will Chamberlain holds both the 1st and 3rd place scoring marks. 1st, of course, for 100 points. And 3rd place all-time with 78. Anytime Wilt's name comes up, you are making history.
The Clippers have gotten 6 of their 12 shots to drop for him here in the second half so far. Gallinari inside the 3-point line. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Kuzma's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. In the corner, it's James. Gallinari with the steal. To the paint. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. That's 12 points for Williams.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe.
And got it! Another basket!
And that puts him even for 3rd on the single-game scoring list. Simply amazing.
I'm at a loss for words. Greg, his has been one of the greatest offensive games we'll ever see.
And to equal a mark set way back in 1961 by Will Chamberlain, that tells you all you need to know.
The drive by James hits it again. Wow!
James. He has been simply unstoppable.
And he's now 3rd all-time for points in a game. 1 for 3, and another one falls.
And he is ripping through this defense and continues his assault on the record books.
That score moving him clearly into 2nd place for most points in a game.
To think that he has eclipsed Kobe's mark of 81 and now has his sights set on 100. This is a game you'll be talking about for decades.
For 3, Ingram. That one falls through. It's his 6th make from the floor this game. Now 6 for 10.
And what a great start to the second half. They've hit everything they've looked at thus far.
Marjanovic, no good. These guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assist.
Incredible. All right, the coaches are going to ask you to stay in front of LeBron James, but seriously, you want to get in front of that?
Gallinari in the corner. and out of bounds as the Lakers gain possession.
And here we can check out the story on Avery Bradley. His last 10 games, he's getting around 8 points a game, 2 assists, and 2 rebounds. And guys, no question, he's a guy with some talent. But honestly, even he'd like to see those numbers improve.
From all the whispers that we've heard, he's been working hard on his game. It just has not showed up yet in the box score.
The Lakers have made 10 of their 14 tries at the free throw line in the game. Free throw good, LeBron. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, he's checked in for the Lakers. Rondo comes in for Ball. And then for Los Angeles, Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Harris. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Bradley. And both free throws good for James. And here's Beverly. He brings it up for Los Angeles. They double him with James. And Beverly kicks to Gallinari. Looking to end the run. Chandler with the rebound.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
The offensive rebound. And he comes up with the deuce. Kuzma's got 4 this quarter.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
And Los Angeles guys shooting 47% since getting things started in the third quarter. There's the feed to Harrell. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. And that one's good, Marjanovic.
And those close-range shots are what you want him taking. They always have a great chance of falling.
James with it, now guarded by Gallinari. It's good.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Montrezl Harrell, seen by many as a throw-in in that Chris Paul trade, has paid huge dividends for the Clippers.
Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense in anticipation there to stop it. And good, he hits it again.
90, a legendary performance.
We'll be talking about this one, Greg, for a long, long time. Here's Beverly. He has 5. Ball's knocked loose and stolen by LeBron. He got it again! Sensational!
He just notched 92 points on that one.
Simply surreal. GA, I'm not sure even he can believe what's going on right now. Marjanovic kicks to Williams. Beverly looking around. And here's Gallinari outside. Sinks the three-pointer. Gallinari's got 11 points here in just the second half. And with Harrell standing 6'8", he seems undersized, Brent, but his wingspan measured over 7'4".
Well, the wingspan and the effort that he plays with, which is hard to measure but easy to see, makes him very unique at that position. Long arms, very strong, and just runs the floor. I mean, he just takes off down the floor and hard to stop once he gets going. Well, he makes it look effortless out there. Until the defense actually presents a challenge for him, expect those kind of results.
And that one's good, James.
Yeah, he's a heady player. He knows how to get himself going and giving his team a real advantage right now on the offensive end.
A baseline J, and it's the Clippers with the rebound. Here's Williams. And that one, clearly a foul, gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up. It's on Tyson Chandler.
And Sweet Lou Williams came into the NBA straight out of high school. I don't think a lot of people remember that back in 2005. The former 45th pick has more than exceeded his selection spot over the course of his career. Last year, winning the Sixth Man of the Year award.
Los Angeles calls timeout. And you look back on Lou Williams going in the second round, pretty surprising considering, Brent, he accomplished so much in high school just in the Atlanta area.
Yeah, the National High School Player of the Year, a state title. He graduated as the second all-time leading scorer in the whole state of Georgia. He continues to fill it up in the pros. He's unstoppable at times.
Let's Los Angeles with some changes. Lance Stevenson's checked in for James, and it's Josh Hart in for Caldwell Pope. Scotty's checked in for Los Angeles.
Break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for Williams. Brent, Lou Williams last season dropping a career-high 50 points on the Golden State Warriors in a regular season game.
Well, he led the Clippers to that convincing win on the road against the defending champs, and you better believe he saves his best game for the stiffest of competition.
And Williams drops them both.
Now, what sets Lou Williams apart right now is his confidence. This guy is a gunner who comes in and believes that he's going to score. He often does.
It's good.
Cannot give players that kind of positioning, and the defense also late in trying to alter that shot.
Down low, and Harrell slams it in.
Well, he's like a fumbling banker right now, dropping dimes with ease. I like how well he led his teammate on that possession.
Hart. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Rondo's got 6 assists in the game.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
Beverly, the pass to Scott. Rondo against Beverly. Down to 5 on the shot clock. The Clippers need to get off a shot. And it's out of bounds to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession.
Out of bounds.
And a look here at the shot chart for Bradley.
Well, you have to give him credit because he's done everything he can to help contribute, but it doesn't appear to be in the cards for him tonight. A lot of strange releases, and he just isn't the same efficient scorer that we're used to seeing.
Gallinari against Stevenson. 6 to shoot. With the clock winding down, and Harrell slams it in.
Well, and there was just enough space after that screen for Gallo to fire that pass over to the open man.
And it's Stevenson finishing it off.
And he wanted everybody in the building to feel that ferocity.
And we did. Yeah. We felt it. Even over here, we felt it. 1:37 left in the third quarter of the game. Williams kicks to Harrell. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
Tough to fault him for the struggles of the team so far. He has been solid. It's the rest of the guys that need to come along for the ride.
Josh Hart, that's good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
The Clippers shooting it really well. 54% from the floor. Williams finds Scott. Back to Williams. Kuzma pulls it in. Kuzma's got his 8th rebound here tonight. Shoots from the baseline, and there's another one for the Lakers.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Bounce pass from Beverly. Williams with a clean look. Off target with his 3.
It's just been an off night for him. That doesn't happen all that often, but the thing that you do at this point is not to push it, not to rush it. Let it come back to you.
And Los Angeles guys shooting well, 52% in the third. They came to play offensively in the second half. Here's Scott. No good on the shot. Chandler with the defensive effort. Hart, that's good.
Josh
Hart's got 10 points in just the second half.
And he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Williams fires, and he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops.
We've seen this before from Lou Williams. Jumper very consistent.
Hart, that's good. Hart's got 18 points.
Well, this is a gravity game right now. Whatever he throws up must come down. He's having a great game.
Stolen by Stevenson. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. Lakers ahead, opening up a huge gap. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
You know, anytime a guy's in the post and the teammates know he's unselfish, great player movement can create an opportunity just like that.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Taking a look at Los Angeles, they've got Thornwell. Harrell is out there with Mike Scott. Then it's Robinson, and it's Wallace in at the point.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
He kicks it to Harrell. Guys are slimming down, it seems, Brent, to play at a faster pace. And we hear more and more players are using a plant-based diet now.
Vegan-style players.
Maybe not quite to that extent, but they are certainly very, very cautious about what they're putting in their body.
I think we just hear more stories about some of the things that players are trying in order to get themselves to their athletic peak. And one of those things, of course, one of the most important things is the fuel that you're going to put into your body, because that's your only tool. So I think guys just pay a little bit more attention to how it is they're feeding the system.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
That free throw, no good. And he sinks the second. The Clippers shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them. Robinson for three, and he's good on the three ball.
And you can see the play calling this half. Another one from distance.
Yeah, no question. It looks like they've rented out room along the perimeter in this ball game, and they're likely to keep doing this until the defense makes an adjustment.
Here's Thornwell. He's guarded by Stevenson. Inside. From close range, Wallace misses. From deep. But they'll get another chance. Count it. Good. That's now 8 points for Lance Stevenson.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
Tipped away. To the inside. Here's Thornwell, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points.
This is where you got to put a body on the guy. His will is incredible down on the interior, fighting and clawing for every rebound.
Not shy from outside. There's no doubt about that. Spreading the floor and getting them up.
Last break, the Lakers. Stevenson with the ball, and it's Beasley finishing it off.
And at full speed, he still has the wherewithal to get himself in good position.
Yeah, the snap decisions right there. Reading the situation on the move and then making the right choice.
Robinson kicks to Scott. Off target from three-point range. For Los Angeles, they've gotten four of their six shots to fall so far here in the fourth. A pretty nice efficiency there. No good from Zubats. For Los Angeles, they've gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Inside, here's Harrell, lays it up off the glass.
Yeah, that's pretty much a perfect pass, and that's also alliteration.
Here's Beasley. The shot from the low post is good.
That's a gorgeous assist. Outstanding at finding his guys in the spots where they want the basketball.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 3 of 6 in the field so far in the fourth quarter. And that one drops.
Commending the unselfish play there. What vision on that pass.
Here's Hart. That one's not going to go. And it's the Clippers taking it the other way. On the wing, Wallace. Out to the wing. Back to Robinson. Banked in off the glass.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
Still attacking, building on this lead, coming down the stretch.
Well, tonight his pinpoint accuracy has been impressive.
Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, he's checked in for the Lakers. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Marjanovic has checked in.
One shot, mind the lanes.
And done a much better job from the line this half. They've gotten that percentage up over 80 for the game.
Wallace outside. Scott up top. Back to Wallace. Pass to Marjanovic. Second shot opportunity, and the layup is good.
And that is one thing he does very well. His intensity on the glass helps lead to these high percentage putbacks for his team.
Hart, no good.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Thornwell kicks to Marjanovic. Outside, Scott to the paint. Wallace misses. Lakers have gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. And that one's good by Stevenson. We love the sneakers these players wear. Now so many different styles. A lot of different signature shoes out there.
I'm not really a sneakerhead myself, Kevin. I didn't really fall down that rabbit hole. But I know some guys in the league, and we've seen photos of their closets at home, filled with
hundreds.
I've seen guys pushing thousands of pairs of shoes. Now that is dedication.
Worth a lot of money.
No doubt about it. And some of the guys, Kevin, don those specialty sneakers in big time games. And the one guy that comes to mind for me is PJ Tucker. Lots of play from PJ Tucker about some of the things that he strapped on last year during the finals. Phenomenal use of the body there to free himself up from the defender and get a clean look at the basket.
Easily in the post. Scott's there. The shot's good. And it's 6 points for Michael Beasley.
He does not play the score. I mean, he's going to continue to work his tail off on the glass and make plays just like that.
That's the kind of guy who does things that breaks the backs of their opponents because they're about wanting it more than the other guy you're up against.
Scott against Beasley. 6 on the shot clock. Basket counts.
Tyrone Wallace.
Wallace has got 4 points now in the quarter. They are enjoying the commanding lead.
And it really gives them the opportunity to give their starters a rest. Always critical when you get ready for that home stretch. That was just a perfect possession. Getting it in tight for the high percentage shot.
Here's Robinson. Here's Marjanovic. It's hauled in by Zubats.
And you got to give him credit there. Great effort to contest that shot.
Well, I love the fact that they put the security system on their house, protecting the paint there.
And Caldwell Pope able to hit those mid-range shots consistently, but that's one the defense will live with.
Robinson passes to Marjanovic. Here's Thornwell. He's guarded by Stevenson. Robinson, that's good.
Well, they brought the double team to force the ball out of his hands, but failed to rotate off the pass.
Caldwell Pope for three. The Lakers keep it alive. Fresh 24. And that one, good.
Defensively, you cause the miss, but then you have to corral it.
Well, that's the second part of the equation there. Block out, be aggressive, and control the glass.
Marjanovic.
Oh, why dunk you very much?
Yeah, he can really fly, and you combine that, Greg, with some nice penetration, too, and you've got 2 points. And that one is good by Beasley.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
Wallace kicks to Scott. Good on the three-point shot. Scott's got 5 points in the quarter.
First three of the half, second of the game. Can he heat up?
And they pick up two.
I mean, the stroke looks good. He's moving well out there. What a sensational start to this game. Perfect from the field.
Robinson passes to Wallace. Robinson against Caldwell Pope. Robinson up top. And it's out of bounds. The Clippers able to retain possession here. And the Lakers with some changes. Chandler comes in for Ivica Zubats. And it's Lonzo Ball in for Hart. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Beverly's checked in. Four on the shot clock. Here's Scott. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
That gives him his second three of the half with three total for the game.
Here's Wallace. And out of bounds as the Lakers gain possession.
L.A. Ball.
A chance to check out Los Angeles' upcoming schedule. On Sunday, it'll be the Sacramento Kings coming into town. And then on Wednesday, they'll go up against Russell Westbrook and the Oklahoma City Thunder.
And it's going to be home game after home game after home game for this group. So they got a great chance to string together a number of wins given how strong they've been playing.
Here's Beverly. To the middle. Here's Thornwell. And the layup is good after an ice lead pass.
Well, it's the golden age of point guards, and Patrick Beverly trying to show that he belongs amongst them. Great awareness on that play.
For three, Caldwell Pope. The rebound by Marjanovic. Marjanovic has got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. And that one's good. Patrick Beverly.
Artful passing on that play, showing a real desire to set up the teammate.
Here's Ball from beyond the arc, and then some.
And Ball is great at pulling up quickly, easily shifting from dribble to that shooting motion there, and there's no hitch in that giddy up.
Out to the wing. Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Wallace, the pass to Marjanovic. And Marjanovic with the slam.
Straight power, homie. I mean, he ripped it down with both hands.
Absolutely a resounding dunk. Here's Caldwell Pope, and that one is hammered home.
Really most effective when he's in attack mode, and KCP with the athleticism to do it.
Here's Beverly. Here's Thornwell to the wing right side, trying his luck deep, and it's Beverly missing. Caldwell Pope on the wing. Wallace covering. That shot by Caldwell Pope, no good. Wallace outside. Pass to Beverly. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Beasley.
Clippers ball.
Zubats is checked in for the Lakers. James comes in for Lance Stevenson.
Ivica Zubats.
Here's Wallace. Inside. And Marjanovic with the slam.
And that's such solid, fundamental basketball on display right there, guys.
You talk about it all the time, Greg. Yeah, great use of the pick to set up a dunk.
Well, that's a play that only works by practicing over and over and having a great rhythm with your teammate. You could see the timing there.
Josh Hart, he's checked in for the Lakers. Outside, Scott to the inside. And the shot goes in from Thornwell. Thornwell's got 6 points in the quarter.
Artful passing on that play, showing a real desire to set up his teammates.
He is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. A minute 50 left to play here in the fourth. Chandler with the steal. And James throws it down.
Hey, guys, got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
A terrific anticipation using the hands. How are you not protecting the basketball in that situation?
And he placed that pass out in front of him and let him just run into it.
Yet another bucket.
Can you believe it? He's done the unthinkable and tied the record for most points in a game.
Nobody can deny that this is one of the greatest individual efforts, GA, we've seen
Not just in basketball, but I dare say in any sport, complete scoring dominance.
100 points for him.
And yep, another basket.
Kevin, now I'm in disbelief. He set a new all-time record for scoring in a single game.
Well, Greg, a record that was for so long thought to be untouchable. He continues to amaze.
And he has now passed Wilt Chamberlain's legendary mark of 100 points, one that stood for over a half a century, unimaginable. And listening to these fans, they are ecstatic with the way he's filling it up.
Greg, an incredible game he's having. One to remember for sure.
Well, put a hand up, put two hands up, an arm, a leg. It's not bothering him right now. All of these shots are just working. He's a force on offense.
Of our Jordan player of the game, LeBron James.
And guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed. It's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
And this is exactly what a star player is supposed to do. Coming off a loss, he made sure they weren't going to make it two in a row. Thornwell kicks to Beverly. To the paint, here's Marjanovic.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Lakers.
A beautiful pass doesn't always get you on the highlight reels, but there were some spectacular dishes in this game.
But you know what? It was a team that was in sync and just trusted one another to take the right shots.
And I think a great job in positioning themselves for the W here. It's win number 21 on the season. The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for LeBron.
You have to focus on the steals he came up with. They were huge factors in the end result.
Here's Hart. Another possession, another assist. And that's his 20th assist. Wow.
Just doing a great job at orchestrating the offense.
To the inside, Wallace goes to the reverse layup and traps it in.
This is not the team we've been watching for most of the night.
It's a shame because this is the team we expected to see fighting on every possession. I think it's just too late.
With the teardrop, and Thornwell gets it to go.
Timeout. That floater is a thing of beauty, effective when it's used the right way.
Los Angeles calls time.
Put me on, son. The hatin' got a price to pay. California on my license plate. Last year they ain't even like the back. Had to get it on my own. I could really get it if I want. Can't even get it on the phone. You ain't even know. I be with the yeah. I ain't gon' stop with no. Run a home mother slang. Yeah, bad bag on my gang. Yeah, big bag with a pain. Yeah, you ain't really what you claim. Why you always in a way? Bad little ways. Bitch, you gon' make it shake. Say you buy it, but you ain't.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Lance Stevenson's checked in for LeBron. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Ball. And the Clippers making a change here as well. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Scott. Offensive rebound. Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the basket.
So close to getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy playing aggressive instead of playing it safe.
There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Inside, Harrell. And Harrell slams it in.
Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see him get up like that.
Chandler, no good. Here's Thornwell. He's guarded by Stevenson. And Marjanovic with the slam.
Outstanding entry pass there. He knew exactly where to go with the ball. And you can tell they're ready to start celebrating. Hey, a well-deserved victory here tonight.
Yeah, you can see the fans. They've already started celebrating themselves. A gutty performance.
And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. They poured it on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. LeBron, were you satisfied with the team's performance tonight?
We got a very good team, but in order for us to continue to improve, we have to go out and we have to defend, we have to play for one another, and we have to be selfish. You know, it's not about the individual, it's about the team, and if we all give in to what the team needs to do to be better, then we'll be okay.
It is a work in progress, LeBron. Thanks for your time. Kevin?
All right, David, thank you. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. So long and good night, everyone.